What's up, guys? In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix the problem when NPCs are not moving or interacting and issues with controls when playing Project Slayers on your mobile device. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. While playing Project Slayers on your mobile device, you can double tap on the top side of your screen to edit your controls, such as your block button position. This will fix issues when your controls are overlapping or blocking interactions with NPCs. You also have the option to log into Roblox on your PC and move your location within the game to fix location-based glitches. In your Roblox settings, make sure to enable the Performance Stats option. This will show you the current ping to the server. A high latency can cause NPC problems, and you should proceed to switch your connection to fix this issue. In case this did not fix for you and you completed the tutorial to the game, then there is a problem with your current game files or with your network connection. First of all, exit out of the game and open up your App Store or Google Play Store. Here, look up Roblox and make sure to download any update that might be available to you. Next, open up your device settings. On iOS devices, scroll down and tap on General. In your General settings, select iPhone Storage. It might take a couple of seconds to load your storage information. Ensure yourself that you have at least some storage left in order to properly run the game on your device. Roblox will read and write data in the background, which will require some storage space on your device. Search for Roblox, and from here, you can offload the app, which will clear your cache but keep your game progress as it's linked to your Roblox account. When this is done, you will not only have more storage space, but it will, in most cases, also fix bugs you are having with Project Slayers. Lastly, you should make use of a speed testing site or application, such as Speedtest. Here, you can preview your average download and upload speed. To improve your connection, try switching it from cellular to Wi-Fi or vice versa, and restart your router in case you haven't done this in a while. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions, and see you in the next one.